Automation Direct offers a huge variety of fiber optic cables for the OPT series sensors. Let's see if we can break it down so we can figure out which cable you need. First, decide what type you need, through-beam or reflex. The through-beam is when you have two separate heads. One transmits light, the other receives it. When the object passes between the fiber optic heads, it breaks the continuity of the light. In this case, the sensor normally expects to see the light, and when the light goes away, it triggers the output. We call that dark on. We triggered the output when the light went dark. The through-beam OPT series optic cables, when used with the OPT series amplifiers, can be used out to about 19 inches. Some of the cables have a smaller diameter fiber core, which gives you a tighter bending radius, but it also gives you a shorter detection distance because it collects less light. This piece of plastic is just to make the diameter of the black jacket thick enough to fit into the sensor. Just slide it down the cable to the length you need, then cut the fiber with the included cutting tool. The thicker plastic fibers, you just cut those normally with the cutting tool. The cutting tool is included with the fiber optic cables. There are several different head types to choose from: panel mount in M3 and M4 sized, these long bayonet style probes which you can bend, these straight barrel types in straight and sideways looking for applications where you don't need threads, flat mounted cables so you can bolt them right to a panel that shoots a beam right out the end or sideways, and panel mount for right angle. The reflex cables have both transmit and receive cables in the same head. One shoots the light out, the other receives the light reflected back. Some folks break that up into retroreflective and diffuse. Retroreflective works like a through beam. The amplifier expects to see light from the reflector, and when an object breaks that beam, the light goes away and triggers a sensor. So we also call that dark on, because the output gets triggered when the object blocks the beam. Diffuse is the same setup, but now we wait for an object to pass by and reflect light back to the sensor. So since the object is reflecting light back to the sensor to trigger the output, we call that light on. The reflex cables also have a lot of options: bulkhead mount, the longer bayonet style, smooth shafts with straight and sideways looking, long rods that you can bend to get into tight spaces with both straight and sideways beams, flatheads for mounting on the surface of a panel, again both in straight and sideways configurations, and a right angle bulkhead mount version. There's two types of cable configurations in the optic heads: parallel and coaxial. In parallel, the fibers are aligned in the head side by side. If I hold the other end of the cable up to an LED, you can see the fiber bundles are side by side or parallel. This is one side, this is the other. In coaxial cable, the receive fibers are arranged concentrically around the transmit fibers. Let's hold it up to the LED, and as I switch fibers, you can see the pattern of fibers in the head. Here's the transmit fiber, and here's the receive fiber. This coaxial arrangement of the fibers makes this cable ideal for detecting very small objects. The narrow transmit beam pinpoints the small item you want to detect, while the large ring of receive fibers gathers the reflected light from that small item and returns it to the amplifier. When using the coaxial fiber, you need to be sure you get the right fiber in the right hole of the amplifier. On this one, there's a little arrow on the plastic to remind you how the fiber should be oriented. There's also a note on the bag that it comes in. And of course, you can always see on the sensor which hole is transmitting light. With parallel fibers, it doesn't matter which hole you plug them into. There's also a variety of glass fiber optic cables in both through-beam and reflex styles. These are ideal for harsh environments because of the steel jacket and because glass fibers are not as susceptible to corrosive environments as the plastic fibers are. Glass fibers can also handle higher temperature environments, although the plastic ones are a little better at the low end. If you have any questions, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support team during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions directed at Automation Direct support staff there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis.